Xenoestrogens. Has anybody ever heard of these before? What these are things in our environment that actually mimic hormones in our body. In this case, estrogen. So one of the biggest reasons estrogen is getting out of control is because we're surrounded by it all the time. It's in all of our plastics, it's in a lot of our cleaning products, it's in your cosmetics, right? It's in the food that we eat, it's in the water that we drink every single day, it's all over the place. And so it's getting into our body more and more. This is why girls are getting puberty at 6, 8, 10 years old, because of so many xenoestrogens that are going on. Why people are hitting menopause earlier and earlier, why men grow boobs. You know, this is a big reason of why that happens, and why so many people now are having trouble getting pregnant, why we're having more testosterone and erectile dysfunction issues going on, because the xenoestrogens are out of control. And here's how that works. You have a site on here, a receptor site, which basically acts like a cup, and the right things come in, they feel that, and the body does what it's supposed to do. But if you get these xenoestrogens in, they come and they block that site. So now you're just getting this free-floating estrogen going on inside your body all the time, which is not good for anybody. So where's this stuff coming from? These are the top xenoestrogens that's around in everything. Number one is soy. Soy is super bad. Right? Just not that long ago, everyone was praising soy, how amazing it is. Oh, you know, this fat-free, great-free source of protein. It's so amazing. But it's not. It's really bad for you. And the problem is, this is in so many different things. It's in protein bars, protein shakes. It's in, you know, non-fat stuff all the time. It's in a ton of vegetarian and vegan foods, all the fake meats. It's all over the place in that. And so that's why these people who are, you know, supposedly vegan and healthy are sicker than anybody. It's because their hormones are out of control. And so you got to pay attention to soy. And it's not just non-GMO soy. It's all soy. Because it all acts as xenoestrogen. And what it does is it increases the estrogen in your body, for men too, and it lowers your testosterone. Right? So as we age, naturally, men, your testosterone starts to go down. It's a normal thing. But if you have a bunch of these xenoestrogens in, it goes down at a rapid rate. So what does that mean? That means that you store more fat. That means that you have less muscle mass. That means that you have less energy. That means that you age faster. Your reproductive system isn't as good as you want it to be. You don't have the energy that you want to be. Your strength goes away. Basically, your body withers away because we're not having that good, strong male hormone. And I don't know about you guys, but for me, don't want that to happen. I want to keep it up as high as I possibly can for as long as I can. Because just like with women, the testosterone replacement stuff that more and more men are on, sometimes, you know, behind closed doors, has a ton of side effects too. Next one is sugar and carbs. So again, this increases estrogen in your body, and you're getting lots of sugar. It decreases progesterone, which in this case is a good thing to balance that out, and it plummets your testosterone. Even a few grams of sugar drops that for like 6 hours or more, and it just starts going down. So if you're a guy trying to get in good shape or trying to lose weight or get more fit, but your testosterone is going down, makes it super difficult. That's why we gotta get the sugars out of there. This is a big one too. Food, drink, and plastic containers and cans. You know, you look at the normal cans, they got that silver lining in there, right? That's BPA, bisphenol A. And what that actually is a xenoestrogen, a very high level xenoestrogen. So if you're eating canned foods and it's not a BPA-free lining, you can actually look for that on the can, and that's exactly what you're getting. All the water bottles that we have that are made of plastic, if they're not BPA-free, like Alhambra and, you know, Calistoga or whatever they are now, those are the same way. All the plastic Tupperware containers you have at home that you put your food in, same thing. And now here's the worst part. When you heat that up to 90 times more of that gets in there. So if you have a plastic bottle of water in the car, you sit it there and it gets hot. I've done this before. And you go in the car and you drink it, you get 90 times the bisphenol A floated right in there. Pretty gross, right?